This is Openly Hostile Opinions with your host, Casey and Jay.
What the hell is wrong with you?
I can do anything I want to, people, at any time I want to.
Now we're cooking with evil guys.
Get mad now! What the voice of people must be heard. Bigot, rape, and discrimination. The crime which are weakening America against you.
Hey, let's get this party started.
Mom?
What's up, bitches and snitches? This is Jay, that's Casey, and we're on the Openly Hostile Opinions podcast.
Hello, everyone. How are you doing today? Hope you're feeling sexy and slutty and whorish. And
sexy again, because why not?
Yeah,
you know, we get the first fucking like couple rays of sunshine. Now we're all trying to think about going on the beach and putting on bikinis. So make sure you ladies shave that camel toe. You got to start shaving above the knee again.
Yeah, above the knee. Oh, man. And that's the thing. I think a lot of women don't shave just because it keeps them warmer during the winter.
I think they don't just because it'd be a pain in the dick to shave all the time.
Yeah, whatever. Speaking of that, we're going to talk about that later.
I don't even shave my fucking face. I couldn't imagine trying to shave damn near everything from the forehead down.
Yeah, I heard something funny the other day because some guy's getting pissed about people saying how manly beards are. And he's like, they're not that manly. Pussies grow hair. I was like, he has a point.
No, he doesn't. Hey, my beard will come to his house and fight him.
They have vaping competitions, so I wonder if they have like beard growing competitions.
Of course they do.
Oh, yeah, they actually do, because Ron, he goes to like this lumberjack festival or something.
Because of course he does.
Yeah. They're pretty serious about it. They actually have a Miss like lumberjack pageant. It's like Miss America for lumberjacks,
except for they all look like lesbians from Vermont.
Yeah, whatever. Pussy's pussy. Speaking of summer, I thought that I would get a summerish beer today. Baseball season started. What was it? Friday, I think. I don't even watch baseball, but I thought, you know, I'd get a baseball beer. It is Victory's Summer Love Ale.
Summer loving happened so fast.
Bend her over, stick it in her ass.
Ha ha!
Ha ha! And it says flavor of the season. We'll show you a picture of it here. Looks pretty fancy. Has a nice little, I like the little 50s girl back here with the little fan and the beach ball.
That's not on our label.
What's that?
That's not on our label.
Really?
That's
probably too much for the kids or something like that. It's a, they have a Liberty Bell here. I don't know what that has to do with summer.
Victory's based out of Philly.
Oh, it is?
Uh-huh.
Oh, I thought it was based out of like, what is it? Harrisburg. Trogues. Is Trogues Harrisburg?
Yeah, something like that.
Oh, okay.
But no, it's the label says with with love from Philadelphia, you idiot.
No, I don't know if I want I don't know if I want any love from Philadelphia. There's probably AIDS there.
Everyone's got AIDS.
AIDS.
Dude, I lived in Philly for a little while.
No, really?
I was going to college down
there.
So
that's what's wrong with you? I can't help it. So let's go ahead and give this a try. I have a feeling it's going to be maybe either citrusy or very light.
I don't think it's going to taste like anything.
Yeah, probably not. Cheers.
It's like one step above Bush.
Actually, it has more flavor than I thought it would.
Don't you agree? It's all right.
That's a weird aftertaste.
Yeah, it kind of does.
Sort of tastes like dog.
We're also drinking it fairly warm, too, today, so that's not helping any.
Yeah, I bought it cold. I don't know why it's sort of warm. I don't know. It is sort of like, it's chilly out, but it's I don't know.
It's supposed to be almost 70 tomorrow, so I'll take it.
Oh, my goodness. Jesus Christ. I better get out in the sun.
Those of you in California right now, it's like 70. We need to put on a fucking jacket.
Yeah, I know.
The fuck?
When I went there, it was like fucking 50 degrees, and everyone was freaking the fuck out.
We got a couple listeners down in Florida, too. They're probably like, 70? Man, I'd be freezing. I'd have to put my shorts away.
Like 70 degrees, that's about everyone's age out here. Florida, God's waiting room. I don't know what I'm saying. I'm going to be old and senile someday. Well, old, I'm already senile, but that's another fucking story.
Insanity is not the same as senility.
Yeah. Jesus Christ.
Would you get that shit out of your system?
I can't help it.
I feel
it.
So bad for our listeners.
I was eating cottage cheese, and it's sort of building up in my throat. I love this.
You're supposed to wait for the infection to clear up before you eat the puss.
Oh, yeah. That's for anyone that doesn't know what yeast infection looks like. It sort of looks like cottage cheese with pepper on it.
A little bit of green mint jelly mixed.
And I don't think my friend watches this, but I have a friend that got it twice from the same girl. You dumbass. And then he got it on his leg. I think it was prom night, too. He got it on his leg. I was like, I didn't know you could get it. I thought it was just like, I thought it was just open wounds, basically, like vaginas.
Dude.
I know. We're right off to the start with some good topics today. I'm a little loopy. I barely got any sleep last night.
That seems to be a recurring pattern
for you. I just can't fucking help it, man. Yeah, me talking about World of Warcraft, big surprise. But last night...
Hey, stop it. Stop now. Rate the beer.
Just
rate
quick.
The fucking beer.
Oh, okay.
Replay the thing. Replay the thing.
Yeah, this beer, there's not much to it. There's actually a lot more flavor than I thought it was. But it's basically summer love. That's basically all it is. It's for getting all your friends with your little ball caps and stuff and sitting there eating, you know, cheese-filled hot dogs and getting diabetes from, you know, mama's pudding or something. I don't know.
Or since I'm vegetarian, I guess a kale burger.
how long do you plan on doing this?
Until I stop?
No, until you're just sick of it.
Till I'm done?
Yeah, that's when I was done. I was on for like a year or some, 2 years. I forget, and it just got annoying. Because you have to tiptoe around so much food, and it's just like, oh, God.
Till I'm done. That's funny. Yeah. Okay, wait a minute. Stop. Rate the beer.
I can't help it.
Give it a damn number and some weird description.
Okay, since Jay won't let me talk about World of Warcraft, I'm going to rate it 3 out of 5 for Azeroth.
I'll go 2. I think it's all right. It's okay.
Yeah, I just thought it would be good for baseball season or whatever like that. That's about it. And I don't even really like baseball.
I used to umpire it. I'm so
you used
done.
To be an umpire?
I used to umpire Little League, and like the parents ruined it for
me. Oh, yeah. That's why they have to start putting up signs now and shit to say, please do not, you know, these people are volunteers. Please calm down. This isn't like for the World Series or anything.
Yeah, it's like, okay, maybe I made a bad call or two. Maybe I didn't. Who knows? Shut the fuck up.
Mm-hmm.
Like, don't set a bad example for Timmy, you jackass.
Yeah, and that's a funny thing. I used to referee dodgeball.
Yeah, you did.
And people take that shit seriously, believe it or not. Holy fuck, man.
It was a bunch of drunken middle-aged men.
Yeah, exactly. I don't know. It's so ridiculous. My friend was like, hey, we need a referee at the YMCA. I thought he was joking, but he wasn't. It was fucking weird.
Ugh, okay, geez. now you may move along. We have this nasty habit of forgetting to rate the damn beer.
Oh, I rated it. Yeah, I just didn't get a lot of sleep. Because Mondays are the last day before everything resets. Like, and wow, everything resets. So I had to get like a bunch of shit done last night. And I was trying to help this Canadian. A. Her name is Mama Bear.
A.
She's been in the guild for a while, but she taught for like the first time last night, and we're like, and I was trying to help her get this fucking dungeon done, but these people were horrible.
Hey there, Casey, don't you know, could you come over here and help me get this dungeon complete, eh? I appreciate it.
It was so god awful. These people were horrible.
And that there we lose half of our Canadian audience for my terrible impression.
No, they're too nice to be upset about it. Anyway. It's like that meme with the guy protesting, Canadian protest that says, I'm sort of upset about this.
That's a misconception.
Yeah.
Because Canadians are rednecks.
Yes, they are.
And some of them are extremely nice, but other ones are just about as crazy and rough around the edges as, well, our neighbors.
Yeah, they're just polite. Any other country's polite but America. We're a bunch of fucking assholes.
I don't know. Southern hospitality is a thing.
Yeah, not anymore, though, really.
I went down there, people were...
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, it still exists, but it's not like it used to be, like, fucking, I don't know, ball gowns and all that shit. That's what I want.
Southern hospitality, not like the fucking, it's not like torn out of the pages of War and Peace.
It should be. Like, I don't want the women to talk and just cook. That's about it. Just joking. Am I? I'm just joking. I respect women.
Are you pulling a Trump?
Nobody, what, I ordered my steak well done?
nobody respects women as much as I do.
Yeah, right. Yeah, me and Jay were talking about that. We found out Trump gets his steaks well done. He eats it with ketchup. We're like, ugh.
So well done it can rock on the plate. That's this is who you pick to run the country.
I know, it's so disgusting.
The well-done steak eater.
Yeah, ah. I don't know. Me and Jay, we've cooked for a long time. If you get anything over, like, medium, you're fucking stupid. Like, what's the
and
point?
And there goes the other half of our audience.
I just don't get it, man. It tastes like nothing. It doesn't taste, there's
it
no.
It tastes like shoe leather.
Yeah, there's just no fucking, oh man, you might as well eat a fucking 90-year-old's vagina.
I like a steak done about medium rare.
Yeah, that's what I like.
Pre-vegetarian.
Mm-hmm.
Steak done medium rare, a little salt and pepper, and maybe a little Worcestershire sauce.
Yeah, that's
for nice. Those of you who don't know what that is basically fermented fish juice that's over 2 years old.
That's what it is?
Yeah, they take anchovies rather. Huh. Anchovy puree, put it in a barrel, pickle it in vinegar for over 18 months, add onions and garlic and some other shit to it, and that little pungent brown liquid that's left is Worcestershire sauce.
Oh, holy shit. You can say that well. I know a lot of people, I sometimes too can't say it, Worcestershire.
Technically, if you want to pronounce it like British people, it's Worcestershire.
Ugh, fucking British.
Well,
fucking British.
Every time I used to go somewhere where I'd order some sort of steak, I'd have to order Worcestershire sauce, so I got used to saying it properly.
Yeah.
Because otherwise I'd look like a retard. Yo, can I get some of that there Worcestershire? Can I get some of that meat juice?
And give me a Busch Light.
I want some of that meat juice.
And shovel water. Oh, hell, it's her birthday. Grab her a Diet Pepsi. Fucking, what movie is that from? Waiting. That's what it was.
Yeah.
From. Yeah. I love that fucking movie. That's great.
Thought that movie was going to ruin the food industry for a while.
No, because you know why? Because the food industry ruins you.
Well, some of that shit's true, but I have never, in cooking for a living professionally for over 14 years now, something like that, have never seen somebody fuck with somebody's food intentionally.
No.
Unless it was like your friend and they don't like onions and you purposely would put onions on something.
Yeah, exactly.
That was about the end of it.
I know,
like,
and that's
I've
the thing.
I've never seen anybody spit in anyone's food. I've never seen anybody drop like a steak on the floor and throw it on a plate.
No, I've never seen that either. And I bet you there is some places that do it, but a lot of restaurants are very strict about that shit because it's just, it's, I don't know what word to use for it. Just not... I don't know. Not very integrity-like.
Not very integrity.
I just said
your command of the English language is astounding.
I don't give a fuck. Whatever. I think most people that go to college these days are retards because they're brainwashed. So I'm not going to college to get me an education.
The sad part is both of us have gone to college, but yeah. You know.
God, that was god-awful. I remember going to college, and they're like, our first class, we're going to... My whole first class was about how not to write in text. That was my whole first class.
Wait, what?
Yeah.
Can you elaborate on that slightly? Like, don't take the whole show explaining this class, but
it was an English class, and our first the whole class was about how to write properly. Like, don't write in text because they have these fucking jackass kids that come
in. Oh, you mean like in like shorthand and emojis, like
yeah, these people write papers like. About this shit that they were supposed to, you know, read about and everything in text, like writing it or whatever.
They typed out LOL.
Yeah, like LOL or BRB or, you know, they'd put instead of I's, they'd put or U's, or instead of, you know.
Y-O-U, they'd put the letter U.
Yeah, or like.
Or yours, you are.
Yeah, exactly. Just stupid fucking shit. It's just.
Hey, whatever.
I sound like Alex Jones there.
Hey, this brings me to something interesting I heard recently.
It's not mine.
It was brought up by a great YouTube channel. If you get a chance to check it out, it's called Today I Found Out. I might have mentioned it before, but if I didn't, Today I Found Out. Anyway, it's lots of new facts every day. But one thing they were talking about is that the rest of the world, for the most part, pronounces the letter that we call Z as Zed. Mm-hmm. And but since since American media is becoming so prevalent, even in foreign and European countries, they hear the word Z a lot. So a lot of their younger people are pronouncing the letter Z instead of Z. Mm-hmm. And they actually have to be taught in school the quote-unquote proper way to pronounce it because they're like getting brainwashed by our way of saying it.
It's what we're good at.
It's kind of like, you know, like arse has become part of the American English language, even though it fucking irritates the crap out of me. Uh-huh. Because I'm not British, goddammit.
Yeah.
I have nothing against the British. They have a very delightful way of speaking.
Yeah. And that's another thing. Like, we spell a lot of words. Like, I think, I can't remember if it's Europe or like Asian, or not Asian, which part of Europe, but they spell color different.
Britain uses U's in a lot of shit.
We spell it C-O-L-O-R. They spell it C-O-L-O-U-R, I think, right?
Yeah, they have a lot of U's and stuff we don't. Color, neighbor.
They spell artifact different, I think.
I don't know about that one.
I'm pretty sure. But that's actually a topic I wanted to cover today. It's funny that we started getting into this because the dictionary just added 300 new words, and I'm not going to go over them.
I applaud that segue.
Dab. I never thought I would dab on this show, but, you know, it's actually pretty fun.
I just love how we talk about our fucking segues and shit.
Like, I know. Like whatever.
Peeling back the curtain here. Anyway, continue onward since we're on the subject.
Yeah, because of the internet and everything like that, words are changing so much. They're actually becoming words now, and it's just...
It's, like dab?
Yeah.
Dab. I can't do it.
I know. I'm like, I can't get a full dab going on because my microphone, I'm going to hit wall. It. It's going to like swing around, go ka-dong. But yeah, just some of these. This is your favorite, Jay. I know that. Alt-right.
Up until then, I called them fucking Nazis, but whatever.
Yeah, Nazis is already a word. Yeah, but alt-right is now a word.
Well, they had to come up with a politically correct term for the bunch of degenerate scumbags who hang out on sites like Breitbart.
Yeah, I know. It's fucking ridiculous. I don't know why this is in the dictionary now. Cat cafe.
Wait, what?
Cat cafe.
Okay, then.
Cheat day.
That has been in my lexicon for quite a while. My whole life is a cheat day, which is why I have bitch tits.
I don't know. I'm probably pretty sure because of the extreme in your face, hey, look, I work out.
I work out.
That's on the fucking internet. I'm pretty sure that's why that's on there.
You know what? Honestly, they're less lazy than me, so more power to them.
I know.
I don't get annoyed by it.
I do.
That's because you're lazy in there. Like,
man. I'm not fucking lazy. I fucking work my ass off, goddamn.
Deep down inside, it makes you feel like, damn, maybe I should go be doing exercises right now, but nah.
No, that's like when I see a hot fitness girl, I'm like, why isn't her mouth on my penis? That's basically it. Depth. Okay. Moving right along. Cold brew. That's sort of boring.
Yeah.
This is my favorite, dad bod.
Can we describe this?
Dad bod?
Yes, dad bod.
It's like how they were saying that dad bodies are in now these days. Yeah, you got
sweet.
You got a dad bod. And a dad bod, actually, we should Google this real quick to show what a dad bod is. Because, what was last week?
You guys should really check us out on YouTube if you don't. It's a good time. I mean, and our YouTube channel is brought to you by Jay's Man Boobs and Casey's Receding Hairline.
Exactly.
If that's a dad bod, then I'm fucked.
This is a perfect.
I'm just a fucking slut. I'm Jabba the Hutt.
That's a perfect example of it. You're just, yeah. You're not. Physically,
it's a beer gut.
Yeah, it's not, but it's not really a beer gut. It's just you're not ripped and you're not like overly obese. You're just a dad.
I'm Jabba the Hutt.
Yeah, exactly.
Mookie, Wookie, Solo, Sucky, Sucky, Dicky, Dicky.
Exactly. And that's actually a perfect example. That's exactly
probably. Is that Vince Vaughn?
Yeah, it is Vince Vaughn.
Okay.
He was actually in Hacksaw Ridge movie.
Hacksaw Ridge.
Yeah, and he played a serious part for once in his life. I was surprised.
Man, he was serious as fucking MIB. I thought for sure he was going to invade us.
He was in Men in Black?
He was like one of the main, he was like the bug. He was the main character, the bad guy.
Was he?
Yes. They just had a bunch of prosthetic makeup on him to make him look all weird. But yeah, Vince Vaughn.
I guess. Holy fuck, man. This is great. This is probably because of, you know, Pinterest. Friendiversary.
The fuck is that?
I don't know, dude. When did me and you meet, Jay? I guess that would be our friendiversary.
High school, so.
Yeah. I don't know what this word means. Hangry.
The only time I've heard it used is on an SNL skit where Kel Mitchell and what the hell is his name?
Keenan.
Thompson.
Yeah.
Keenan Thompson. They had a little Good Burger throwback thing on SNL a while back.
I did see that.
Or no, it wasn't on SNL. Duh. It was Jimmy Fallon.
Oh, was it?
Because Jimmy Fallon.
That's right. He played a customer or something, didn't he? Or he worked there.
No, Jimmy Fallon worked there, and Ed was training him.
Mm. I remember Good Burger. That shit was fucking hilarious.
Well, you know, it's like everything else from the 90s that we love so much. Mm. Speaking of which.
No. Please, God, no.
You better set that thing to not restart.
How do I turn this thing off?
I don't know. Windows 10's trying to restart. If this happens, we're screwed.
I fucking hate this shit, dude. This.
I think you're good.
You can activate up to 18 hours from your start time. What time is it now?
I don't know, but I think we're okay.
Are you sure?
I think we're okay.
Why?
Because it said we'll do it during unused hours. All right. So you better restart this thing before you try to render the video.
But it says you could set up. What are the active hours?
I don't fucking know. I run Linux.
I don't want this to happen. I hate it.
This is our show, folks.
I've been updating this computer for like the last past fucking week now. What else does it need? Am I not on it enough so it can't spy on me as much as it wants to?
Your soul.
Is that why it needs to fucking keep updating? Holy shit, man.
Dear Microsoft, fuck you.
Yeah. God damn it. Here, we'll change it like this. Active hours, let us know when you... Okay, yeah. So we'll change this to 9 a.m. Come on, you fucking piece of shit!
Okay, well, while he's getting...
To 10 p.m. All right, I'm good.
Okay, you do your thing there. Speaking of like shit from the 90s that's awesome besides Good Burger, did you hear that The Undertaker is retired?
Yes, I did. Poor man.
The Taker. The Taker's gone. I never thought we'd lose The Taker.
He was my favorite, man. He was such a badass. Ugh. You've been using that more than I thought, man.
I know. I get more use out of that than I thought I would.
Yeah, I...
The dead man.
Yeah,
the dead man has laid his hat, gloves, and trench coat down.
Yeah, we were watching. We were like, God, this is dramatic. What is this, Lifetime?
I'm not going to lie. I feel sort of sad.
Yeah, I miss Paul Bearer, that fat fuck.
The sad part is I didn't realize that was a pun on Paul Bearer.
Yeah.
Like the guys who carry the casket until like this year.
Yeah.
And I'm like 32.
I never want to hear you make fun of me again.
Unless I get a girl. Still have plenty of reasons to make fun of you.
Unless I get a girl pregnant, then you can make fun of me all you want. Hey-oh. Dab.
Hey, being a parent's a rewarding experience. Don't make fun.
Yeah, I guess. If you have lots of chloroform. But yeah, I guess the... You're just hitting shit now, aren't you?
No. Baby's poop.
Yeah, that's true. And I guess the Hardy Boys came back, too. I guess that was a big fucking deal.
Hardy Boys came back.
I didn't even know they retired. And they still look the same. I saw a picture of them. Like, do they age? Jesus fucking Christ, man. They don't have dad bods.
The Taker kind of did.
Yeah, yeah.
He's getting a little chunky in his old age.
He is fucking old.
He's like 52, though. Can you, like, fucking wrestle at 52?
I'm actually surprised. I thought he was older than that, to tell you the fucking truth, man. He's been around for a long, long, long time.
Well, that man deserves a break. The Taker was the best.
Yeah,
he was. He had that period in the late 90s where he was, like, a biker, which is sort of stupid.
Yeah, I hated that. He came out of a motorcycle to, like, Limp Bizkit. Get the fuck out of here.
I like the dead man character, though.
Yeah, that was pretty cool. I just loved it. And it's like, I don't know why I think it was Limp Bizkit or something like that.
I don't know.
I've liked Limp Bizkit once, and that's when a really, really hot stripper came out to it once, and I was like, I've never liked
rolling,
Limp Bizkit.
Rolling. Keep rolling, rolling. Dude, I hated that shit when it came out, but now if I hear it, I'm like, what you want to do now? Yeah.
He did have nostalgic. A catchy voice. He was like, hey.
It was fucking nostalgic.
Oh, man.
I get some nostalgia. When he did Behind Blue Eyes, though, it was like, you are not good enough to do this. Go away.
I know. That was so fucking retarded. That was, ugh, why? Why?
You stay away from the Who. You leave it alone, and you go back to your corner.
Oh, Jesus.
If you want to cover If you want to cover Grandmaster Flash, that's fine. You want to cover the fucking who, you go to your corner and think about what you've done.
Cover Oko Ono or whatever that bitch's name is.
Yoko Ono. Was that last week's show?
No, I think it was the week before, actually.
Yeah, whatever. Yeah, that was the week before. Chuck Berry, man. I'm telling you, if you go scroll back in our socials, you got to look at that video.
In our socials.
It's on Facebook and Google Plus. It didn't make it to Twitter because it was over the fucking 100 and whatever.
Yeah, that's fucking annoying.
Character count.
I actually like dabbing. I think it's fun.
What? I don't do it right. I know I don't do it right.
I know. I have no idea how to do it. But, yeah, so now that my computer's not going to, you know, go all Skynet on me.
Go AWOL.
Yeah, let's get back to some of these. So what we end with there? Hangry?
Oh, yeah, hangry. I'm hangry. It means I'm hungry and angry.
That sounds like a Southern thing, you know, when you come home to the plantation. You're like, Mama, put on the food. I'm hangry.
You know, most Southern people don't even talk like that anymore.
No, really? Yeah, it's actually
the same thing as, like, TV and shit.
Because you were talking about, and I was going to bring that up, but I forgot, is that they're losing Southern accents because kids are watching so much TV and stuff like that. We talked about that before.
Yeah, they watch TV shows which are overwhelmingly made in the, you know, like New York, East Coast area, and they're made in Hollywood, which they both have that general, basically what we have, the Northeastern accent.
Yeah, and it's funny because when I used to live in Florida, I never knew I had an accent until I moved to Florida.
Well, of course, you don't have an accent to you. It's just normal.
I know.
To them, it's an accent.
People down in South, for some reason, they think, or I don't know, I guess we sort of do this. But when we ask a question, I guess we say it louder.
We have an upward inflection.
Yeah. To all the things that they notice, that's what they notice the most, is when we answer a question, we get louder. Like, hey, what do you want? Or I think
maybe New Yorkers do that. Yeah. I don't think we do.
I don't know. That's what he said about me. He said it about both me and Jimmy, so I have no idea.
No, Jimmy's just Jimmy.
Moving right along, what the fuck is K-pop?
Korean pop.
Oh, shit.
Like,
makes me horny.
Like, what's his face?
It gets me drenched.
What the hell is his face? He blew the fuck up at the most watched video on YouTube for a while.
He blew the fuck up.
Oh, yeah, you know.
Was he a suicide bomber?
No, you idiot.
And that reminds me, is every suicide bomber, every time he takes a picture, is that a photobomb? I've always wondered that. I was going to sleep one night and I was like, huh. Now, what are you looking up? The guy that...
Oh, I'm trying to think of his fucking name. He had that huge hit. It was giant.
It's not Baby Metal, is it?
No.
Oh, fucking Gundam Style bullshit.
Yeah, Gundam Style. Psy. Gangnam.
That's K-pop.
Not Gundam Style. Why Gundam's like fucking Mobile Suit Gundam.
Gundam.
Oh, no, Opa Gundam Style.
That is a catchy fucking song.
Even my little death metal heart, I like... every time that song got on, I screamed like a little girl. Oh, my God, it's on! Like I'm doing a little horsey ride.
That's probably where dabbing came from, because that's the dance, and they were probably like, oh. That's pretty sad when that has to be in the dictionary. This is fucking beautiful. Lightsaber.
Really? It took them that long?
Yeah, and it's actually pretty funny. I just seen a picture of this strip club, and they had a sign out front. You fucking piece of shit. And for some reason, the sign said, Lightsaber Night is canceled. Fuck you, Tony.
I don't know what Tony did, but I want to know.
Yeah, at a strip club, I don't know what Lightsaber Night is, but it sounds awesome. This is how we don't get copyrighted, is we just put our microphones up to my laptop. He is a dad bod.
Yeah. Dude, this shit's badass. I don't care who you are. Every time this stuff came on the radio, like, oh my God, it's on again.
Oh, dude, it's so funny, girl. Man. It's so funny. I love it, too, because, like, the one part, he's just sitting on the toilet.
Like, yeah, why not?
Yeah, I don't know. I still hear this song every once in a while. A lot.
The sad part is it's going away. It needs to come back. We need another sigh.
I know. He never had a fucking another really hit after this.
Well, not in our country. Maybe he's huge there. I don't know.
Nah, he probably is. There's an explosion for no reason. Jay, someone of your size should move like that.
Hey, he ain't far off.
I know, he has the dad bod rocking.
He definitely got that. He's got that fucking big-ass Korean head, too. I can't say shit. I got a big head, too.
He does have a big fucking head.
He does.
That's why I'm surprised. I guess dad bods are in over there, too, I guess. And there's random women doing yoga. All right, you better turn this off or I'm going to get a boner.
All right.
The whole Asian.
I had fun with it. Okay, let's go on.
Man bun, which makes me want to kill myself.
Hey, shut up. When I had long hair, sometimes you got to get that shit out of your face.
You didn't do a fucking man bun, though.
Yeah, I did.
Not the ones used today.
Oh, I fucking straight up did.
Oh, Jay, don't talk to me anymore. I'm done. See ya.
I straight up did.
I'm out.
I straight up did, because you know what? It kept it out of my face when I was working on shit.
Oh, man. What, your game with women or what?
I'm married. The fuck do I care?
You didn't used to be.
Well, I didn't have a man bun at that point.
Yeah, if you want to get married, I don't recommend having a man bun. Yeah, where we live, I've seen one. I'm like, they're out here even.
I used to rock it. I'm not ashamed.
I'm like, hide your children.
Hide your wife, hide your kids, hide your wife, hide your kids.
Next one we have here is mic drop. Because of rap music, probably.
That's new.
Or that Verizon commercial.
I'm actually surprised that some of these are just now making it, because they're not new.
Yeah, I know. And that's the thing. Like, I just have no fucking idea. And I don't know what the fuck this word is.
Sext.
No, that one above that. Patricore? I have no idea what that. We'll just skip that.
No, now I have to know.
Oh, now you have to know.
Well, spell it.
P-E-T-R-I-C-H-O-R. I have no idea. I've never seen
this. A pleasant smell that frequently accompanies the first rain after a long period of warm, dry weather. Other than the petrichor emanating from the rapidly drying grass, there was not a trace evidence that it had rained at all.
So it's another name for moist.
But
I'm going to start you. It's very petrichor.
It's been around since 1964.
And they're just adding that?
The fuck?
Some of these are fucking hilarious.
The term was coined in 1964 by two Australian CSIRO researchers, Isabel Joy Bear and Rich. That is the most Australian name ever.
What?
Isabel Joy Bear.
Going to get up by a mate.
B-E-A-R. Richard G. Thomas for an article in the journal Nature.
That's so fucking weird.
Well, that's.
I've never heard of it before.
I mean, a word that's been around since the 60s, you kind of can't, like, call new.
Yeah. I wonder if Wolfdog Gundam Style's in here.
Gundam Style.
But, yeah, there's just a couple left here. They didn't list all 300, but they're sext. I'm surprised that it hasn't been in yet. Slay.
Yeah. Slay?
Yeah, like, yo, dog, sure, I slayed that.
I'm pretty sure metal bands have been using that to describe
I know.
Violence for a long time.
Smackdown.
Now, I know that's been on since the 90s.
I know.
And I'm pretty sure The Undertaker was on it a couple of times.
Every Thursday. Well, that's when it was on when I was younger, was every Thursday.
Smackdown!
Yeah. Superfood, because, you know, you got those foodies out there. Teachable moment.
I love how you're skipping over that one because you can't pronounce it.
Yeah, I don't know.
Stochastic terrorism?
Stochastic terrorism. I don't know. And then Uncanny Valley. I don't know what that is.
Uncanny Valley is.
It's like another name for, I don't know.
Okay.
A valley with tin cans.
No, the Uncanny Valley is. Okay, say. Oh, good example. The Polar Express. You know how that. It looks really realistic, but not quite, and it's sort of creepy.
So it's sort of like the Pixar movies and shit.
No, it's just like anything that's sort of creepy. Like, it's almost human, but not quite, and it fucks with your mind, and it makes you just get the creeps from it. Like another good example of, like, android robots and shit that are really lifelike looking till they start moving their mouth. They don't move like humans, so it makes it like, ugh.
So if I see a weird vagina, I can call it an uncanny valley.
If the vagina were to be artificial, yes.
Or the gush wound. Yeah, I was doing Quizzle last night for the trivia thing, and I mentioned the word gush, and this fucking lady lost it.
Gush!
Yeah, she was like, I don't know, in her 40s, 30s maybe? And, like, I thought the kids would laugh, but this lady just, she was from Germany, I guess, and she just lost it. And then I was like, why is it so funny to you? And she's losing it. I was like, I bet you moist is funny to you. And then she fucking went off the
deep. She had to go outside, catch a breath.
She was funny, though. I was like, this girl, this lady's great. Bring her on in every fucking Monday.
And just so we know, the stochastic terrorism is apparently the use of mass communications to incite random actors to carry out violent or terroristic acts.
And it has to be actors.
No, not like, Actors as in pawns in the game.
Pawns, okay.
Yeah. People.
That's fucking
weird. It's like remote control murder. It's like the Manchurian Candidate sort of shit.
Yeah, that's been going on for like how long? Why is that? I don't know. They Dictionary, just, you weird.
New word.
Dictionary.com, you weird.
All right, so there's a detective who was busted for masturbating in strangers' yards.
Oh, great. How'd they know? Shit.
Here's what it gets. New York Police Department, because of course it was. He would go into Long Island homes and stand in their yards, and he would... he would use his flashlight and shine it until he got someone's attention. And as the person was looking at him, he'd like shine the light on his dick as he's jacking it.
Why is that a thing? I don't. That's like what
I don't know. It's no different than back in the day. Your parents tell you stories about that guy who had the trench coat.
I know, but that's the thing. Like they want you to see it. Like they're not
that's
sexually
how they get off.
Turned on until they see it.
That's like, how they get off.
That's dude, so funny,
dude. There's a like an entire group of people out there whose sexual fetish, I shit you not, mm-hmm. is to rub their like. Semi-erect dicks on people's asses in like the subway and shit. Oh, got a good rub on that one.
I understand that.
And we learned something about Casey today.
No, actually, last time I went to New York City is when the Ebola shit was going on, and I had a friend going with us, and she was sitting there like that, so scared because of the Ebola stuff. And I was holding one of the poles, and she looks at me, and she goes, Casey. I go, what? She goes, the pole. I go, what are you talking about? She goes, you're touching the pole. She goes, Ebola. And I go, I take my hand off the pole and I go, and I pretended I licked my hand and she was like,
I'm not sure if it's Ebola you got to worry about doing that.
I know, but I didn't really lick my hand. Yeah, I did. No joking.
Ew.
Yeah, but that was, I'm actually surprised this didn't happen in Florida for once.
Yeah, everything else happens in Florida.
Actually, Family Guy just made fun of that. I was watching it before I was closing down the restaurant the other day, and they were headed to Florida, and it said, "Welcome to Florida, the home of the United States weird news."
there's this video out there right now. I should have actually put this up earlier. Speaking of people from Florida,
no.
Wait a minute, it wasn't Florida. It was California. Never mind. I'll shut up.
Yeah, California's the same.
Well, California, some chick loses her fucking mind because two people who were not white skinned, I guess,
mm-hmm.
Kissed each other in the line.
Yeah,
and she lost her fucking mind.
What do you like? Was one like black and the other one was white, or were they both black, or were they both Asian, or
indeterminate? I don't know what they were, but they and then she assumed that they were foreigners, I suppose, because, you know, that's the fucking popular thing to do right now, I guess.
What, be a foreigner?
No, assume, be mad at foreigners right now, you know.
That double vision. Like,
what I'm saying is this woman voted for Trump.
Oh, okay.
If you follow me here.
Way to stereotype there, Jay.
If I'm wrong, if I'm lying, I'm dying.
I'm surprised someone from California had a race issue. They're usually very, what's the word I'm thinking of here? Accepting of other countries and their rape, I mean ethics. And
okay, let's see here. She calls it like a bizarre, like this woman just loses her mind. It's completely crazy.
She yell, "You're a prostitute?"
Yes, yeah. Here, let me see if I can bring up a video and we can just listen to it. Listen to the audio.
Okay, all right. If she's mad that it's a prostitute, like doing her thing.
No, it's not a prostitute. Here.
Then leave. Why are you here? You have your food.
Excuse me, I have a right to be here. This is a place where you eat, not where you make out of that food. Go get a room.
We are waiting for you to finish up, so we're chatting.
Go make out outside.
You're a heinous person.
I hate it.
You're a prostitute.
Hate it.
Go make out while you're in front of everyone, like a slut, while we're trying to eat. There are people here.
Okay.
Okay, this doesn't sound like a race issue. This just sounds like she was disgusted that people were, like, making out.
It becomes a race issue further into the video.
Where's the finish line?
They literally, like, kissed once, according to the people on the video. That's
okay.
This is not a place for this.
Can't wait till this hits YouTube.
That guy.
Don't do it, because it'll just sit there.
I can't wait till this hits YouTube. That's hilarious.
While we're trying to order.
Step back.
Excuse me?
He's like, step back.
Excuse, do not tell me.
Step the fuck back.
Excuse me?
Step the fuck back.
Excuse me?
Excuse me?
Can you call the cops on him?
I'm getting all this on video.
See, this is why people that work in restaurants want to fucking kill themselves.
Your girlfriend in a public restaurant acting like a prostitute.
They kissed once.
I like her.
You told me to leave while I'm in my...
You're probably related to her.
No, she doesn't have a nose like me.
Okay? You're such an airhead. You're so dumb. You're sexually harassing me.
Oh, here's the woman thing.
Well, you are harboring a lot of shit.
That was good.
I don't want to watch you make out with that person while I'm trying to order
good.
Food.
There's the door right there. Yep.
What?
Oh, no.
I want my money back.
Oh, God.
I want a refund.
Jesus fucking Christ. Jesus fucking Christ.
Because this is the restaurant's fault.
I know. I know. They're like, Monday night's make out night. If you're not satisfied, you get your $20 back.
Talk to the manager. Talk to me.
I'll give you the tape.
What is it, an ice cream place? Looks like there's ice
cream. Nah, they get, that's like salad stuff.
Oh, okay.
I want my money back.
I want my money back.
This is so ridiculous.
Okay, whatever.
Go to hell, prick. Go to hell, prick.
Sexually harassing me, making out with that bitch?
No one's sexually harassing you.
You're having sex with her, Kisha.
The sex was pretty good.
Go get a room if you want to fuck the whore.
Sex was pretty good.
It's disgusting. It's disturbing. You making out with that ugly bitch?
I think. Whoa, shit. I think she's jealous. Because she wasn't getting made out with. When you start.
For the record, the chick bitching is not real attractive.
Yeah, she's not. She's not. She didn't get her $20 back. There's like a bunch of people there, bitch. You're like fucking embarrassing yourself.
Another guy in the line starts kissing somebody.
You're a dumb bitch. Fuck yourself. You are such a whore. You are such an asshole, both of you.
Yeah, this girl is harboring a lot of issues.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Bye now.
You're stalking me.
I can't do it anymore. I can't do it anymore. I can't do it anymore.
Please.
Oh my God. I can't.
Yep.
Dude, like, you're stalking me. He's telling her to leave.
There it is.
Is that the girl that she was making out with?
Yeah, she's talking right now. Go back to your own country.
She is pretty ugly.
No.
That's the
makey.
Go back! Go back, you retarded foreign asshole!
Yo, he's more wanted here than you. Leave! You leave!
I'm the manager. Excuse me, there is a man that was having
He was having sex! Oh,
all right, you get the gist of it. Yeah, she's like, go back, you foreign asshole. At one point, he goes, I'm from California. It's like, well, go back there.
Oh, Jesus.
And that's why the guy on the video is like, there it is. Like, that's the issue.
Oh, man, whatever.
Look at this poor busboy or waiter or whatever. He's like, God, fucking Tuesdays, man.
Oh, that's so great, man.
Yeah, that's the girl who was getting made out with.
She's still butt.
She's not that greatest looking chick in the world, but dude, come on. I'll see if I can link this video. I got to try.
Yeah, share that with people for people that aren't watching the YouTube.
Well, nobody saw it because
I thought we had it on the video, but we don't. Yeah, check that out. It was pretty funny. Yeah, that bitch was
I didn't plan ahead. I had no. She was hangry.
Hangry.
She was hangry.
She was hangry while someone was sexting.
Oh man, no, I've never seen that. That's pretty funny though.
Oh my god, this is like she's like fairly fat too, yeah. And it's just like, you know, she's unattractive. She's fat. She's angry. She just needs like a dick. This chick needs a dick.
Well, they say that when you get upset about stuff like that to that extreme, you're just very lonely.
Yeah, she needs a dick.
Yeah, they like when you see other couples together holding hands, doing all this stuff, that's a sign of loneliness. So, bitch, you need to like, I don't get on farmersonly.com.
Yeah, under the livestock section.
Yeah, swipe left a couple times on Tinder. I don't know, get your hole beat up a little bit, something. I don't know. It is, I got to give it to her. It is pretty disgusting when people are making out and shit like that. I've seen it before, but you just ignore it. Whatever.
Dude, they didn't even make out according to what they say. It's just like,
I know, but that's another thing. That's why, who knows? Who fucking knows? He's probably finger blasting her. He's like eating salad. And he's like, I could use some salmon on this. Boop. Get a little flavor.
The salmon. Salmon's probably what happens after she opens her fucking drawers.
Yeah, that's great. Did that happen just recently?
Or yeah, that was just a couple of days ago.
Oh, sweet.
I'll schedule that for Thursday morning at 6 a.m. So who knows if our show will be out, but if not...
Everyone that watches this show is probably a raging alcoholic, so they're probably not up. But
well, I try to give everybody the benefit of the doubt. Plus, we have people in other countries who watch.
Oh, we do? Oh,
yes, sweet. We do.
Hello! You foreigners! No, I'm joking.
Go back to where you came from. You're having sex in the restaurant.
I like it when she calls the cops. She's like, there was people having... I mean, it looked like they were about to have sex. It's like, yeah, bitch, watch yourself. And the stalking part, that was great.
That's stalking me.
That he's telling her to leave, and she's saying, you're stalking me. That's the way women are these days. Every time you say hi to a woman, they think you're, you know, flirting with them. So
yet again, stupid people, not normal people.
Yeah.
Whatever. I'm out of beer. I'm sad.
Yeah, it's a sad day.
All right, how much time's left in the show? I got an issue. I'm out of beer.
Yeah, we got a little bit. Little bit yet. We'll cover a couple more things here.
All right.
We're gonna talk about my favorite thing, Nazi feminism. Yay!
Well, I guess that segues well into that.
Yeah. Speaking of women, always take your hand. Oh, this has nothing to do with that. But
wait a minute. Casey's opinions do not necessarily.
It's called openly hostile, not Casey's opinions. Damn it! You go learn. But
not all women are insane.
Let's I know. I just kid. It's all for the show. Yeah. But this just fucking cracked me up. I was scrolling through Facebook and I read this and I was like, I gotta see if this is fucking true because who knows? It's Facebook. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Or like some people call it Nosebook. Well, apparently.
That explains why you're on it.
Yeah, exactly. No drum roll. So apparently the new Justice movie is coming out, and there was a trailer for it. And big surprise, fat maple syrup waffle-eaten fat cunts are upset.
No, what? Waffles are delicious. Fuck you.
I know, but... Because this is the problem that I have with this whole, oh, stop showing skinny models. It's because you're probably fat and fucking disgusting and you don't have a body like that. And taking this from
I'm
someone...
I'm also fat and disgusting. I'm offended.
Yeah. Wait, what? You don't have waffles?
I do have I have a waffle maker.
Oh, damn. That's pretty nice.
You betcha.
But, yeah, it's just... And this is why feminism, in my opinion, will never work because women are so against each other. It's never going to work.
Women do fucking hate each other.
Oh, man, I know, dude. you guys, this whole body shaming thing, you know, it's fucking getting weird. So, basically, I forget what this girl's name is. I think it's Gal Gadot. Okay. They're pissed because she doesn't have a hairy armpit. She's playing Wonder Woman, for anyone that doesn't know, and they're very feminists are very upset that she doesn't have armpit hair. So remember, don't body shame unless it's a body that you think should be, you know, portrayed. So, hey, don't make fun of fat people, but if your body doesn't look like I want it to, you're wrong.
I gotta find a way to boost the volume on that.
Yeah, so I just...
That's a huge bitch!
There we go.
I just had to cover that because that is the most ridiculous fucking shit I've ever fucking heard in my life. And I
don't you have anything better to do with your time?
But here's the thing. They're also mad because they think her armpits were photoshopped.
In a trail, like for every frame.
I know.
Do they know how Photoshop works?
I know, dude. And
yo, let me bring up that armpit hair filter.
Yeah. Hey, frame 6,072,000.
It's not like Snapchat where it follows you the fuck around.
Yeah, I know. I can't. And that's the thing. This is all I see when I see something like that. It's just jealousy. It's just jealousy that she looks good because she looks fucking good. And I'm going to bring her up.
Hell, I like you. You can come over to my house and fuck my sister.
Fucking man, dude. She, I would drink her bathwater. Let's just put it that way.
Or as a buddy of ours used to say, I'd drink a gallon of her piss just to see where it came from.
Yeah, she is fucking sexy as fuck. I would put it in every hole that she has. I don't know how many she has. But
you make a couple new ones.
Yes, exactly.
I'm pretty sure there's Cannibal Corpse songs like that.
Yeah, probably. She is very, very good looking. And looking at this, you could see why feminists don't like her. You know why? Because they don't look like her. And that's why feminism is bullshit. It's not anything about equal rights. It's about you being jealous cunt. Go fuck yourself. I'm done.
On the other hand, the men going your own way movement and that sort of shit, yeah, they're pretty fucking sad and pathetic too. So don't think we exclude those little
no, we do.
Basement dwelling whiny bitches.
Oh no, and that's the thing. Like everyone's like, God, you talk shit on women so much. I'm like, if I was a woman, I would talk shit about men. It's today's society. Everyone's just turning into, I don't know, spoiled. Ungrateful, just messes. Everyone's a mess.
I think I mentioned this before, but you should go look into this whole men going their own way thing. It's a fucking hilarious.
What the fuck? I don't even know what that
it's
is.
It's like this movement of a bunch of sad, lonely people who apparently can't track them. First off, half of them are made up of the nice guys.
Uh-huh.
the quote-unquote nice guys who can't get a woman and think that, all women only go for assholes and blah, blah, blah. It's like, here's a thought. Maybe they would go for you if you had moved out of your mom's basement, took the fedora off, and washed your hair once in a while, you smelly fat bastard.
Yep, and here's the thing for anyone out there that has either been... Well, first of all, let me give you some advice. If you've ever been trapped in the friend zone, quick way to, you know, fix that. Bring another woman around. If you hang out with this girl that you're trapped in the friend zone with and you see her a lot of places and stuff like that, bring a more attractive girl around. You'll get with her, trust me.
or she'll legitimately have no interest in you, and then you move the fuck on.
No, that's not how it works.
It is, too. I've seen women who legitimately aren't interested in a guy, period.
Oh, I know, but just trust me. Even if you don't get her, there'll be a lot of questions. Trust me. There'll be a lot of fucking questions.
If you're the backup man, then she'll get mad. If you're actually in the friend zone and will never escape the friend zone... She's not going to care.
I don't know. I've seen it change a lot. I've had a lot of friends where I was like, you know what you do? You bring another girl around, and then things changed real quick. Because women do not like other women.
No, they do not.
These little
basement dwelling. I'm not done with this.
It's fine, because I'm going to talk about it more. Yeah.
These little basement dwelling weasels, like, they believe that masturbating, like, steals your power away.
Oh, my God. This isn't fucking Highlander.
There can be more than one.
Yeah.
In fact, if you're around my house right now, I'm clearing the plumbing. There can be a lot more than one.
Yeah, exactly. And here's another thing. If you want to know why women like assholes, it's not that they like assholes. It's just like they like a man. And you beta males that sit in your parents' fucking basement looking at fedora.com aren't going to get a woman. You know why? Because you don't act like a guy. Women want guys. They don't want to date another woman. When you're nice and you're passive, okay, they feel like they're dating another woman. And they don't want to date another woman. If they would, they'd become a lesbian.
And sometimes
they
want to date a man. Sometimes you're just not fucking attractive. Get over it.
I know, but dude, did you ever see there's a lot of fat fucks that get good looking women. You know why? Because they have money and they're fucking dicks.
Fedora.com does not is cyber squatted, by the way.
I'm fucking surprised.
I was just curious.
No,
but
I'm
for
serious.
Sure there'd be.
Dude, I'm serious. It's so true. And it's such a shit I'm making up. I probably say I have more women that are guys that are friends of mine, and I listen to women talk because I find these creatures to be to be interesting. I find women very interesting.
Today, under Deep Blue Sea, we look at the female of the Homo sapiens
species. So I listen when they talk. And this isn't just from like one or two females. This is from a bunch of females. They don't want to date women. If they would, they'd become a lesbian. And that's usually what they say. They want a man. They want a manly man. And that's why, you know, they want a man that sweats, that's dirty, you know, comes home from work. Yeah, there was actually a study that they interviewed all these women, and they said what turns them on the most is a hardworking man that is either around the house or has a hardworking job.
I don't know. I mean, ZZ Top said every girl's crazy for a sharp-dressed man.
Yeah, but that's the thing. So, like, you know, a lot of men, you know, when they go off work and stuff, they dress up nice. You know? They're like, they know what it's like to, you know, when it's time to dress rugged and when it's time to dress nice. I'm just saying, man, I listen to women talk. Did we ever talk about that drummer?
The fact that his name is... Everybody's seen that video.
I know, but I keep seeing it. I still see it till today, like to this day. Is this fucking? I don't know if we talked about this in the show or not, but this drummer goes nuts, and we watched it for a while, and it ended up being at Knoebels, which is.
Oh, it wasn't Knoebels.
Yeah, it is. That's Knoebels.
Is it?
Yeah,
they're at the Texas Bowl. They just said so.
No, I heard it was. I thought it was Knoebels. Wait, rewind it. They say Texas. No, he's saying where we were at.
I don't know, whatever.
Yeah, that's Knoebels. That's the dome. That's where, like, they have, you know, high school bands playing shit like that.
I don't know. I'm sure there's a million of them.
Yeah, probably.
They probably all look exactly the same. Have you ever seen this video? He just goes apeshit. He looks like fucking animal from the Muppets.
He starts out all nice and stuff like that. Then he's just fucking, like, dude, it's insane. We'll try to link that to our Twitter, too, if no one has seen it. But Jay is right. It's a little older. Maybe someone hasn't seen it. I don't know if everyone's up on the memes these days.
The memes.
Yeah. And
I like memes.
I don't know if we mentioned this or not either, but colleges are starting to have classes on meme studies.
Where do I sign up?
Yeah, exactly. So believe it or not, yeah, that's a thing. That's how powerful memes are getting these days. So, yeah, you could go to college to be a meme person.
A meme expert.
Yes, a meme expert, basically. Yeah, so check that video out. We got one more thing here. I've been meaning to cover this for a while, but we've never got to it. But I just think this is cool because I wish I was a hacker.
Yeah, you saw The Matrix once and then you got a hard on.
Yeah.
You're the one, Neo.
Yeah, you're the one. I'll show a little picture of here. So some guy in Sweden, okay, they have electronic bus stops.
And they billboards on the side?
Yeah, and they have advertisements and stuff like that. Some motherfucker hacked them and just put porn all over them. The whole town. Well,
they've done that with, like, refrigerators and, like, built-in tablets and shit. Right. By the way, why would you need a built-in tablet on a refrigerator? But anyway.
I don't know, because people are
recipes?
Fucking lazy. Yeah, so...
Or they want to watch their favorite YouTube show, like Openly Hostile Opinions, on their television while they're preparing dinner.
Yeah, exactly. I just think it's funny here because some lady interviewed and she was like, it was seriously hardcore porn. Like you think, bitch?
It's like, there was some butthole penetration going on there.
Seen Jennifer Lawrence, beautiful submarine.
Oh, yeah, beautiful humans. No.
What was that motherfucker's name?
Ken Bone.
Ken Bone.
It's like some creepy guys are looking at her butthole. Like me, I'm the creepy guy who looked at her butthole.
Yeah, I actually heard someone say buttholes look like starfishes. I'm like, yeah, sort of.
Balloon knot.
Yeah, that's what I always say. They look like balloon knots a little bit like that.
After it pops, though, and you're looking at the inside.
Yeah. Not the whole balloon itself. That's what a hemorrhoid looks like. I don't like it.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ. Amen. Yeah, but I think that's about all we have today. Thank you, everyone. I do want to give a shout-out, though. I do have a friend. I know.
You
I'm
do?
Yeah, I know.
Other than me?
Yeah.
Wow.
I do have other friends that, you know, other people can see. But
wow.
I don't know if she still watches the show or not. But I have this friend named Megan, and she's very sick. She has a very bad thyroid problem. She's in the hospital. she's not doing too well. I think she's doing better. But I Megan, if you're still watching the show, just want to say I hope you're feeling better. Don't die.
Is there anything we could? Should we give some sort of social in order to?
There is actually a GoFundMe. I don't know what it is off the top of my head, but I know it's out there.
We'll find it and we'll schedule that for Thursday post as well. Yes. If you wanna help contribute to,
because she was in for I think 2 weeks, something like that. So her bills are gonna be.
if you wanna help contribute to Casey's friend Megan's hospital bills, I'll go ahead and put that on our socials as well on Thursday.
Yeah, she's. I didn't know a thyroid could kill you, but I guess it's really bad or something like that. And I know she used to watch the show. I don't know if she still does, but being in a hospital bed, maybe she did the past the time. But
yeah, I got nothing better to do than watch us idiots talking about stupid shit.
So, Megan, I hope you're doing all right. Kick some ass. I know you're a tough son of a bitch.
Wouldn't she be a daughter of a bitch?
Anyway. But, yeah, so that's about it. Thanks to everyone. Like we said, we're usually on Twitter. We're all over Facebook. We're all over your mom's face. Never
Google
mind.
Plus.
Google Plus. Check us out on YouTube, Stitcher, iTunes, and Google Play. So that is about it. Yeah. So thank you, everyone. Have a good one.
And buy a t-shirt.
Yeah. See you later. Goodbye.
This has been the Openly Hostile Opinions podcast. 3 and your favorite podcast app. Be sure to like, subscribe, rate, and comment. If you want to help make all this possible, become a patron at patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions.
Good morning!
Morning! Good morning!
Oh, and in case I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.